Good morning and welcome to Sunday School. Today we will talk about a very important topic, especially during these times, which is to honor your father and your mother. Now, if you have a Bible with you or your parents' Bible, or you want to look it up later, we are going to look at the book of Exodus chapter 20 verse 12, which says, "Honor your father and your mother, then you will live a long time in the land. The Lord your God will give you this land." Now, how many of you actually or think you honor your father and your mother? I hope most of you are raising your hands. Now, if you're not, well, here's a reminder. You may be wondering, well, how can I honor my father and my mother? Well, have five ways you can. Number one, respecting your mother and your father, which means do not talk back to them. I know sometimes we get mad and we're frustrated and we just tell them something back when we really didn't mean to do it. And you know, it's okay. Sometimes we have our days, but you gotta remember, you have to respect them because they try to do their best, especially during these times, to give you what you need for school, to give you, you know, to help you be safe and protect you from like this whole virus thing going on. Number two is to obey your parents. Sometimes they ask you, oh, go clean your room or pick up your toys or do your homework or pay attention in class. Or they ask you to stop playing Fortnite or stop being on TikTok so much, and you don't want to. You want to continue because you think you could do whatever you want to do. But you gotta remember that you have to obey your parents. Because when you obey your parents, you're showing God that you can obey Him as well. Because you gotta remember that when you honor your parents, you're also honoring God. Because as believers, He is our Heavenly Father, which makes us, you know, His children. He's our Father. So when you bring honor to your parents, you're bringing honor to Him as well. So you gotta remember that when you're respecting your parents and you're obeying them, you're doing that for God as well. Number three on my list is to help your parents. You can bring honor to your mom and to your dad by helping them out, by probably cleaning your room, washing the dishes, you know, doing the chores you're supposed to do, taking out the trash with all them, asking you, repeating and asking you once, and come on, please, you know, because you're showing them that you're listening to them, you are behaving as well, which is my number four on my list. When you behave, you're also bringing honor to your mom and to your dad. Why? Because you're helping them out, again, to be a better, you know, brother or sister. You can help them, you know, not fight with your sister or your brother. I know sometimes you just want to kick them and push them and pull their hair, or they don't let you play Fortnite, or they don't want to do a TikTok with you and you kind of get in a fight. But when you behave, you bring honor to your mother and to your father, because you are showing them with your actions that you're doing what they've taught you to do, like loving your brother and your sister, or not running around a church, or not talking during service. You know, you're showing them that, okay, my mom told me to, I need to be quiet and pay attention. You know, you're showing them that you're listening to them, which is really important, because when you listen, you obey, and when you obey, you behave. When you behave, you bring respect. Now, the last way you can honor your mom and your dad is by thanking them. This one's a big one, especially during these times, because, you know, it could be hard for some parents to provide for food or to have enough money for the things you need for school, especially now that you are behind probably a tablet, a phone, or a computer. You know, you need internet, and to have it, you need money. And many of the times, it could be your mom or your dad or both of them. They probably lost their job and they try their best to provide you with what you need. You know, and when you go thank them, you are letting them know that you see how hard they work to do what they can to provide for you. probably with the phone, a tablet, a computer for school. You're telling that you see them trying their best to put food on the table. You see them trying their best helping you wear your mask, be protected, and be safe during these times. So it's really important to honor your father and your mother, because some, you know, they could be having a bad day, like we have bad days, and by doing this you can make their day. Now you may be wondering, well, how can I thank them? Well, number one, you can go up to them, give them a big hug, and say thank you for the food today, thank you for helping me with my homework. Or you can take a break from playing Fortnite all day or being on TikTok all day and do them a little card that says thank you, like I did for my parents, which was a little thank you for everything. You know, you could get a construction paper if you have, a blank sheet of paper, markers, you know, draw them a flower, something with their favorite color, their favorite sports, you know. And if you don't have that at home, it's okay. You can always say thank you by doing what you're supposed to be doing. Now, we are going to do today is say a prayer for your parents. We're going to say a little prayer. So now bow your heads and close your eyes. Repeat after me and say, Heavenly Father, thank you for this day and for my parents. Help me bring honor to them every day and continue to protect us. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Now I hope you have a blessed day today. You have awesome. Don't forget to wash your hands and wear your mask when you go to church or you go somewhere else. Hope this was a great reminder on how to honor your father and your mother. God bless you all. See you around church.